Alright, I will show you guys how to find the area between two curves. Here's the first curve, we have cube root of x. And the second curve is 1 over x. And we just care about when x is going from 1 to 8. And on this interval, we see that cube root of x is above 1 over x. So we can use a vertical rectangle approach. So, I will draw a rectangle for you guys. You can put a rectangle like this, where the left endpoint is touching the curve, we can also draw a right endpoint, doesn't matter. The key is the labeling. Notice the bottom here, the base, it's meant to be just a tiny bit of x. So a little bit change of the x. That's denoted by dx. And the height, it's going to be the difference between this and that. And because cube root of x is above, I will denote that by yt. And then we'll have to minus the one on the bottom, so that's yb, which is 1 over x. That said, the area will be the integral, and we can just put down the cube root of x minus 1 over x, and then dx. And we use dx because here, right? And then that's why we have to substitute the functions into the integrals. The cube root of x and also 1 over x. Lastly, because we are in the x world, we will have to make sure, see the x is going from 1 to 8. So that will be the limits of integration, 1 to 8. So that will be the setup. Now we can just work this out. And to do so, for the cube root of x, that's right here as the 1/3 power. So we haven't integrated anything yet. And then, do not write 1 over x is x to a negative 1 because that's a special integral, right? You get a natural log for that. But anyway, right here, go ahead and add 1 to the power here. We get 4 over 3 divided by the new power, so you will have 3 over 4. It's just multiplied by the reciprocal. So the first integral will have 3 over 4 x to the 4 over 3 for the first part of the integral. Next, minus the integral of 1 over x. The derivative of what function will give us 1 over x? Natural log of x. And usually I'll tell you guys to put an absolute value around the x when we integrate 1 over x, but this time though, you don't have to because we are only going from 1 to 8 and they are both positive numbers. So you can enter the 8 into natural log, no worries. If you have the absolute value, doesn't matter anyway. So let's work this out. We have 3 over 4, plugging 8 first, right? So let's go ahead and do that. And then minus ln, and then the x is 8. So that's the first part. Minus the second part, we plug in 1. So 3 over 4, let me just write this down here. 3 over 4. And then 1 to the 4 over 3 power minus 1, ln of 1. All right. Now I know. I will explain this right here real quick for you guys. 8 to the 4 over 3 power. How do we do it? Firstly, take care of the rational exponent, the denominator. That turns into a cube root. Do the cube root of 8 first, right? Cube root of 8. And then for the 4, put it on the outside. For computational purpose, do the inside first with the cube root. Cube root of 8 is 2, and then raise that to the 4th power, we get 16. All right, so we see that this right here is 16, and 16 times 3 over 4 is 12, so the first part here is just equal to 12. And then minus ln 8, and then you don't need a parenthesis if this is only just one number inside of the natural log. And then minus, here is just 1, right? 1 to the 4 over 3 power is just 1. And then we have 3 over 4. And the last part here, ln 1 is 0, so it doesn't matter. So finally, we just have to do 12 minus 3 over 4. So let me just write that down. So 12 is the same as 48 over 4 minus 3 over 4. So that's 45 over 4. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the answer is 45 over 4 minus ln 8. And that will do it. All right, we're going to find the area between these two curves. The first one is that we have e to the x, like this. And the second one is x times e to the x squared. And it's given to be like this. And we want this region. And you see that we want to go from x equal to 0 to x equals 1. And on this interval, e to the x is above the other one. So we can go ahead and use a vertical rectangle approach. So draw a rectangle like this. And you see the base is just a little bit of x. So that's dx. So the top function is e to the x. So remember, it's yt minus yb. And the bottom function is that. All right, so let's go ahead and set up our integral. We will have e to the x minus x e to the x second power. And then we are in the x world, and the x value is going from 0 to 1. So let me just indicate that right here. So that's pretty much the idea. And let's just go ahead and integrate this. Integrating e to the x, we get e to the x. But what's the integral of this? Well, let me do it on the side for you guys. Integral of x e to the x squared dx. Let's take a u to be this, which is x squared. And we see du will be 2x dx. Divide the 2x on both sides, we get dx equals du over 2x. And now take this integral to the u world, we get the integral, x is still x for now, and then we have e to the u, and the dx is du over 2x. And the x and x cancel, but we do have a 1 half in front, integrating e to the u du. Integral of e to the u in the u world is just e to the u, but u is what? U is x squared, so we can put that back right here. Don't worry about the plus e, because that's not the main deal. It's this one right here. So we can come back. We have a minus. The integral of x e to the x squared gives us 1 half. Let me just write this down here. 1 half e to the x squared power like that. And then we can go ahead plugging numbers from 0 to 1. 1 goes in first. So we have e to the first minus 1 half e to the 1 squared. And that's in the exponent. And make sure you also plug in 0. You also plug in 0. You have e to the 0's power minus 1 half e to the 0 squared. Like that. And let me just move my scratch work to the side. There we go. All right, let's figure things out. E to the first is just e, and then this is just 1, so we still have e to the first, but that's a half of it. So minus half e minus, what's e to the zero's power? This is just 1. All right, so we have 1 right here. And then don't forget to distribute. So distribute this and that. So we have a negative, and then minus minus becomes a plus. And here is still e to the zero's power, which is 1, and you have 1 half. So that will give us 1 half. All right, now e minus half e, we just have half e, and that's positive. And then negative 1 plus 2, we have minus 1 half. So half e minus half. All right, let's see how we can find the area between these two curves. The first curve is this sideway parabola given by the equation x equals y squared minus 2. And the other one is this sideways exponential x equals e to the y. it's really just y equals ln x. But since the equation was written this way, so let's use that. So as we can see, this time we have a sideways case. It will be easier if we use horizontal rectangles. So what I mean by that is, have a look. Let's draw a horizontal rectangle right here. This time though, the width is a little bit of y, so that's denoted by dy. And then we will have to look at the function on the right, which is e to the y. And that's, I'll just write it as x to the right, so xr. And then this right here is the function on the left. So that will be xl. So this is xr minus xl. That will be the length of, or the width, or however you want to say it, of the rectangle. So here we go. Area equals integral. The function on the right is e to the y minus the function on the left is that, which is just x. It's just y squared minus 2. But it has two terms, so make sure you put down parentheses. And we are in the y world because we have the dy here, right? Then be careful. We are in the y world, so pay attention to the y values. Y goes from negative 1 to positive 1. So negative 1 to positive 1. And now let's just go ahead and integrate this and we'll be done. Firstly, integrating e to the y is just going to be e to the y. And then minus integral of this is 1 third y to the third power. Reverse power rule. And then don't forget to distribute the negative, so that will actually give us a positive. Integrating 2 in the y world, we get 2y. And then let's go ahead and plug in the numbers. So plugging 1 first, we get e to the first minus 1 third, 1 to the third power, and then plus 2 times 1, and that's just the first part. And then minus plugging negative 1, we have e to the negative 1, and then minus 1 third, negative 1 to the third power, plus 2 times negative 1. All right, this right here, let's just work out the exponents first. So this is going to be e and then minus 1 third and then plus 2. And then let's also distribute the negative. So we have minus e to the negative 1. And then be careful with this. Negative 1 to the third power is negative 1. And then negative 1, let me just highlight this for you guys. Negative times negative 1 is positive, but we have one more negative here, so altogether is negative. So this right here, so let me just indicate that. Altogether we have a negative here, and we have 1 third. And lastly, 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. But again, we have to distribute this negative, so altogether we have positive 2. Right? Yep. And then now let's just put things together. Perhaps let's do the fractions first. So we have this combining with that, and then that will be negative 2 thirds, and then 2 plus 2, which is 4, so plus 4. So that's the same as negative 2 over 3 plus 8. No, we need the denominator 3, so 12 over 3. So that will be positive 10 over 3. All right. And for the exponential power, just leave it like that. So we have e minus e to the negative 1, and lastly, plus 10 over 3. So the first curve that we have is this. We have a sideways parabola, x equals y squared minus 4y, and that's this curve in blue right here. And the second curve is also a parabola, but going the other way. It's this right here in like this purple-ish color. So we have x equals 2y minus y squared. So notice, this is different than the usual case. If you try to draw vertical rectangles, then you can see that this right here, it's that you are saying, okay, some part of this styroid parabola is above itself. Not good. And then in fact, if you move to here, you see how the red is above the blue now. And lastly, if you look at this part, the red is above the red. So that by red is like this curve right here. So if you want to do vertical rectangles, you will have to use three different integrals. But if you use horizontal rectangles, you can just do it in one go because of the following. If you just draw a horizontal rectangle like so, you can see that this red one, or the purple one, it's always on the right of the blue one on this interval. So horizontal rectangle is the key for this question. Notice I put down a rectangle like this. Let's figure out this part. It's just a little bit change of the y, a little bit of y that's denoted by dy. And then the horizontal distance, it's going to be the x. It's always the x on the right minus the x on the left. In this case, the red one or the purple one here, I'm not sure what that color is. The red one is r, is xr here, which is 2y minus y squared, minus the one on the left, which is that. All right? So now let's go ahead and set out the integral. The area will be the integral, the one on the right, which is 2y minus y squared, and then minus the one on the left, which is y squared minus 4y. And then we are in the y world. So I need a parenthesis for both of them. So that being said, y goes from what? 0, and this right here is 3, right? The y value here is 3. So y goes from 0 to 3, that will be the limit of integration. Now let's just clean up the inside before we integrate. This is the integral going from 0 to 3. We have 2y minus y squared, and then distribute, so we have negative y squared, and then negative times negative, and then we have 4y dy. Combine like terms, this is integral going from 0 to 3. We have negative y squared minus y squared. That will give us negative 2y squared. And then we have 2y plus 4y. That is plus 6y dy. Now let's use the reverse power rule. Firstly, we have y squared here. So go ahead and add 1 to it. And then that will be 3 divided by the new power. So the first part is negative 2 over 3, and then y to the third power. Then we add, this is technically what? Y to the first power. Add 1 to the power, we get 2. Divided by the new power right here, 6 divided by 2, we get 3. So we have 3 squared here. So we have this, then plugging numbers from 0 to 3. 3 goes in first, so we have negative 2 over 3 times 3 to the third power plus 3y squared. Y is 3, so 3 here, 3 here. That's the first part, and then plugging 0 as well. I know the result here is 0, but let me just show you guys all the work. Because for now, let's build up a good habit to check when we plug in 0. So 0 here, 0 here. Okay. Now we just have to work this out. So, let's see, 3 to the third power here is 27. 27 times negative 2 over 3. So you can cancel, you get negative 18. All right, and then 3 squared is 9 times 3, we have plus 27. And the rest is just 0. This is just all 0, so that's all good. So finally, negative 18 plus 27, that is positive 9, and that will do it.